Hi and welcome back to Larand Gaming, and if you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Larand and today we are gonna go to Ancient Shores and unlock this special fishing area. We're gonna go through all the quests and what needs to be done to be able to access that area. So we're gonna press this quest, press to track. And we need to talk to Goliath in Ancient Shores. So we're gonna go to Ancient Shores right away. One thing that is good to know when you do this quest is that if you have done other quests or just fish a lot of fish, keep all your rare fish, because when starting this quest you will get a barrel that you need to fill with rare fish. So we're gonna see how many rare fish is gonna be needed. So this is the barrel. It's quite a big barrel. Let's see. Yeah, so first, let's see. So we have 20 rare fish. And if we deliver 20 rare fish, we will get some weights that we need to put on some pressure plates. I think I have already 20 rare fish on me. Looks like it. So that barrel is full. I don't know how that fit in my backpack, but it doesn't matter. We finished this quest, so we got a new item. Scroll up, we have this Goliath dumbbell. Gonna remove my orb and equip this extra weight instead. And we're gonna go to three different locations. You can see them on the map. Actually, you can't see this one because I was too close. But you need to hold it and you need to stand on these pressure plates. So this one is done. We're gonna go to the second one. And you can see it already. It's over here. We stand on this one as well. That's another pressure plate. And then we go to the last one. Over at the opposite side of the island. It's up on the hillside. I'm gonna do a little bit of a fast forward. And here is the last pressure plate. There we go. So now we have opened the entrance to this special area where we have a lot of puzzles, and it's actually quite a lot of puzzles in here. And then we go inside, and here we have a short cutscene showing the area, and this is the centerpiece that is currently being blocked. Underneath you have the special fishing area. We're gonna start with the puzzle. And also here you have a short cutscene showing Bulk, I believe it is. So you have scrambled pieces. You need to open this gate. You need to match the picture on the right side with the scrambled picture on the left side. So what you do here is, so this piece is actually correct from the very beginning, so that's quite easy. But since this is the left corner, you want to put the right corner right next to it. So if we move the pieces like this, so these two, these are corner pieces, they are brought together, then you can position this piece directly underneath this right corner piece. So regardless what you have down here, you move this piece directly underneath here. That way you will move up the piece into the center and you have the top row solved. What you need to do next is, well, actually currently I don't really need to do much. This is already solved. So I just need to bring the pieces like this. But however, if I scramble this, just to explain how to to do this, because that was just way too easy, okay? So what you want to do is to bring this lower left corner directly underneath the top left corner. So if we move these pieces, so you have it like this, and then you want to have the piece that goes directly underneath here in between these two corners. You want to have that one in the center, so you want to have it like this. Then you can bring down this one and put it in the middle. That way the pieces will come together, and that's basically how you solve it. I'm not sure if you understood what I meant. And we activated the crystal, meaning that we have the first puzzle complete. Moving on to the next one. So this is the memory game. You're gonna stand on or run over different pressure plates. When it becomes green, that's a right combination. And then you need to find the next one that becomes green. If it turns red, you have to start it all over from the beginning. So every time this sequence is unique, and it's unique for your user. You can do this together with other players. So if you see someone else running around here, you can also do your thing here because you have both individual puzzles. So you will not interfere each other. And I try to have this entrance always in the back. That way I won't rotate my camera and get lost. So I will just try to find the first piece that turns green. I just run around, see what happens. Let's see where we're gonna start. So it was of course the last one. So we have the start at least. So this is one. And we go and search now for number two. And see where that piece is. Hopefully it's not so far, but it seems to be very far away, of course. That way it's gonna take extra long time to do this puzzle. It's easier if every pieces are next to each other. And of course it was the one that was furthest away, just to make the video longer. So we have number one and number two done. So we redo this. We have number one. We have number two. We're gonna try to find number three. Hopefully not the one that is furthest away again, but we will see. Okay. We have one. We have two. We have three. Okay, so we have corner pieces so far. Two. Three. Four. Nice. So now we have four pieces. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Okay, so we have five pieces. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Excellent. Sometimes you're lucky and sometimes you're not. This went quite well. The start was pretty, well, it was the worst, basically. In the opposite corner, but the other pieces were quite okay. So that's how you do this puzzle, and then we're gonna move on to the mirror puzzle. And the mirror puzzle is actually three different rooms. Regarding the difficulty, they are different, of course, and I believe maybe the second one, the one that is here in the middle, might be the easiest one, and then it's the left, and the hardest one is to the right. That's at least what I think. Once you go inside, this swamp water will start to rise. You have 2 minutes to solve the puzzle. This is a puzzle that you can only do alone, because once you go inside, the gate will close. And there are mirrors inside these rooms that will confuse you because they are not being used, and there could be mirrors also blocking this bright light, so you have to rotate them so they don't block the path. But I will just go in, solve the puzzle, and do a free camera so you can see how I did solve the puzzle, but then also from a bird's eye perspective to see the actual solution. So let's go inside. You have a cutscene here again. But I won't really say that much in here. I will just run through and solve it. First puzzle done. We will see what it looks like from above. So directly when it starts, I go to the left, direct the light up to the roof, across the room, and down again to another mirror that will shoot across diagonally to this mirror, and we will finish off at the crystal. So I'm gonna see if we can get a good bird's eye perspective of this. So that's what it looks like, and you can also see the mirrors that is not being used. All right, moving on to the next one. And there we go. That's mirror puzzle number two. Bring in a bird's eye perspective. So what we do here directly in the beginning, we go to the right instead this time. And this mirror can only go in one direction. And then we go over the plank, go up to the roof or whatever roof we have. And then across the room and then directly finish off at the crystal. And we will continue with the third puzzle. And this is also the most challenging one. And there we go, third puzzle complete. And as you can see, there are more mirrors here that is not used. And this mirror is one of those mirrors that can actually block this light. So if this mirror is rotated so it's more into this region, it will block the light and you need to rotate it in some other position so it doesn't block this mirror over here. This one needs to direct the light so it bounces up and around, and it's a little bit tight here, so it's easy to miss this section and easy to actually not be able to see where this mirror is located. And you shoot it at this fixed mirror on the wall and it will hit the crystal inside the wall. But to actually get up on this mirror, you need to go back to the beginning and go up here. And that's one of the mistakes I did early when I did this the first time. And here we have Easter eggs, of course. Very nice. I like Easter eggs. All right, so those were the puzzles. And now when this is done, we go back at the entrance of the mirror puzzle, I should say, because now we can activate this crystal. And when we activate the crystal, the centerpiece in the first room will start to move and it will reveal the special fishing area. So it also starts the timer of 30 minutes, as you can see down in the lower left corner. And we can go and fish the special fish. Amazing. And this room is beautiful. I love it. It's pretty big. It's pretty open. It's very open. It's very friendly to have a lot of people here fishing. Everyone finds a good spot here, so that's perfect. Lovely fishes in this water as well. I really love the models. And yes, so this is what it looks like. And that pretty much sums everything up. So that's how you do the Ancient Shore special fishing area quests. So, well, in any case, that was all I had for you today. If you do have any questions and comments about this, please put them below. Like this video if you would like to see more content from Fishing Frontier and other Roblox games. Please subscribe, and yes, have a nice day.